John Magnusson, 2013 Distinguished Achievement in Industry Diamond Award winner.
He's definitely an out-of-the-box thinker.
And then this profound ability to communicate his ideas in a very approachable and understandable way.
He is as approachable by the newest employee in an office as he is by his colleague partner.
He's just one of those kind of key fellows that is brilliant, and so brilliant that he doesn't have to prove anything to anybody.
He's been my mentor for 30 some years, and I've just learned so much from both the engineering side and from the business side, how to operate a business efficiently and effectively.
And we have great fun. We get to work on some of the best projects around the world and come up with creative ideas and help our clients achieve their goals.
Structural engineers are responsible for engineering design and analysis. John's firm, Magnusson Clemensic Associates, provides structural and civil consulting engineering services on projects in 47 states and 49 countries.
The expression is often used of structural engineers, they are an architect's engineer. And John is a particularly adept person at doing that, where he totally appreciates what it is the architectural team is attempting to achieve, and then doesn't just support it, but works to enhance it.
So he's not just a local engineer, he's someone who's respected worldwide.
Seattle is often identified with its structures. John has taken the lead on many of these landmarks, including EMP, Benaroya Hall, Safeco Field, and 2 Union Square.
2 Union was absolutely remarkable. There were a number of first design techniques that were used in that building. It's pretty unique at that time.
The Experience Music Project, the thing that makes that building more unique than really any other building is the fact that it's a completely three-dimensional structure. So there are no straight lines. Normally a building, you can take a ruler and go find somewhere on the building where you can place the ruler and it will be straight. And on that building, it doesn't work. John was principal in charge. The question came, how do we frame this building?
And John, being a student of buildings, looked at the Bilbao Museum and tried to understand not only what Frank Gehry was doing, but maybe ways that it could be made even better.
And ultimately, John came up with the idea of using the same structure that creates your torso, which are your ribs. Each rib on a 10-foot grid allows you to basically follow the form of the architectural shape, and then we had a concrete slab that was poured between those ribs that created what we called a steel-stiffened concrete shell. And that allowed any shape that the architect wanted to create, we could frame using that system.
Computer technology and 3D modeling was really in its infancy, and we were really experimenting with how to deliver a building as unique as that. And not really draw it on a two-dimensional piece of paper, but rather use computer technology to deliver the building.
Safeco Field is viewed as one of the best venues for baseball in all of the United States.
And this was really something that John spearheaded and led, but it was something that he was very passionate about.
In building Benaroya Hall, that hall is a box in a box. So when you think then about how you would build this box, and yet you can get cantilevered balconies and side balconies off of this wall without any connections to a backspan, makes that a structural, some might say an impossibility with extraordinary acoustics. But more to the structural side, it has extraordinary isolated acoustics. And structural engineering plays almost more heavily in that success.
Washington State Convention and Trade Center, the two biggest challenges there were how to span the freeway with such a large structure, and at the same time, how to build the structure over a live freeway.
And that's when you turn to the structural engineer and you say, we can do that, can't we? John would always be on the positive side of a question like that, to say, let us look at it. Yes, we can help you. And yes, we think we can contribute to that that vision for the project.
John personally has had 24 projects recognized with American Council of Engineering Companies. He is one of few to be elected as an honorary member of the American Institute of Architects.
That's quite remarkable in its own right.
John's number one passion in giving back to the community is a group called the ACE Mentor Program, which he started in 2001. This group of architects, contractors, and engineers mentor high school students and expose them to the industry.
They have mentored 1,100 high school students, and I believe they've given $270,000 in college scholarships.
He's been very, very involved in the American Society of Civil Engineers and a variety of other national engineering organizations in a leadership role and helping guide our industry kind of move in the right direction, providing safe, reliable buildings, in the end of the day, making the world a better place.
He's made a significant change in our industry, and there's very few people, if any, that I'm aware of that have done what John has done and has the passion for it.